I can confirm his words. They're true life and borne out by my experiences. husband from me, as you know. While he was still alive some years ago, you should have seen me. Young, gay, fresh, rosy complexion, sparkling eyes, firm flesh. Now look at me. I've turned into my own godmother. Now, to keep warm at night, I have to smother myself in blankets. But I well remember how I could fall asleep in mid-December without a fire. Take my word for it. Men are what you need in bed beside you on the winter breaks. Or to give you a squeeze and say God bless you every time you sneeze.
How can you tell me to return Lily and break my vow? What will they think of me?
Lily's an idiot for staying abroad so long. If you ask me, I find it odd that you don't hear from him. Why not be smart and realize he's had a change of heart?
That I will not believe. There is a trace of falsehood in his soul or his face. This noble mouth, this brow, this honest eye. How could I think that they would ever lie?
He does look faithful and sincere, it's true. Maybe you're right to love him as you do.
Yet I can't. Help me!
You dropped the painting! My instant nephew's looked!
Oh, good heavens, she's fainting.
Quick, someone, anyone!
I heard a call. What's wrong?
My lady's dying.
Is that all? The way you screamed, I thought I must be serious. Woman, wake up! Are you dead or just delirious? She doesn't answer.
Water and people to assist. Why, you support her.
She's called all over. I'm afraid it's death. Wait. First, I have to listen for her breath. I'm not a doctor, but I'd almost swear she's breathing still.
What's going on out there? My husband's in your arms! It's vice! It's lechery! I'll run down and surprise him at his treachery!
Hurry up for help! She's almost gone. What's wrong with her to let herself pass on and try and make it to a higher sphere when everything's so nicely set up here?
No sign of it. Call it animosity to flit like that and foil my curiosity. I'm convinced he's up to something. What? The little that I saw explains a lot.
At last I understand. With freezing glances, I get an answer to my taste advances. He's the same as a freezes for some younger acquaintances, while I poor woman hunger.
They're all like these husbands in captivity. Give them their freedom and they take a liberty. In the beginning they're all steam and fire, kisses and poetry, but soon they tire and leave us on our own! Let's modify the law till it allows a wife to change her husband like a blouse. That would be wonderful, and quite a few other abandoned wives would like it too. What's this? A jewel case from someone's pocket? Carbon enamel? Charming. No locket. I'll look inside.
Dead? Ha! She had a spell of weakness. In 5 minutes, she was well. Is that my wife?
A miniature, how neat. He's handsome and the painting's very sweet.
Looks like she's looking at, upon my soul, a portrait. I don't like this rigmarole. The ugly thought has struck me as suspicion.
Workmanship's a marvel of perception. This lady got this gift and now she's missing it. It smells so fragrant. ravishing to have a man so bold and brilliant lavishing attentions on you, bending to your whim. I should be tempted by the likes of him. Why don't I have a husband of this stamp in place of my old hulking brute?
You tramp! That's why you're standing right outside our house dismantling the honor of your spouse. I gathered from your language that you drew the wrong card. I'm not good enough for you. Well, by Beelzebub, I'll have to carry you off. Pray, what would you prefer to marry? A more upstanding man than I? A straighter carriage, spirits more unsinkable? A loftier brow, a thicker hair above? A face and shape more clearly made for love?
Often, would you feel and take a rest? My master's rules, I say, are so enlightened.
I had to look for her. Too frightened. She seemed in love with me, and she gave her hand. And her father promised. I don't understand.
I got it back. Now I can inspect the picture of this ugly dog who's wrecked my wife and life. Don't know him.
How did he come by that souvenir I gave Seeley?
Poor Scottarelli. Your dignity's been dirtied too badly for it to be reasserted.
Before I left, she took that gift to serve as a pledge of love. Reason to be nervous.
My name will be immortalized in verse as Scottarelli the Steer. Or even worse. The world will point two fingers in my face to show how low-born women bring disgrace.
You could be wrong.
Destroyed before my time. Oh, Jezebel, you soiled me in my prime. Some monkey beat your juvenile as far. Splendid image. Forever scarred.
No, I'm correct. It is the portrait of me.
Just watch it.
I'm sure she doesn't love me.
What does he want?
I have to get this straight. Pardon me, sir, but I'd like to speak.
Too late!
I'm curious to know how you acquired that portrait, which I noticed you admire.
He's curious, is he? So is his request. But now I think I see what's on his chest. No wonder he was anxious to converse. He's it! Or to be accurate, he's hers! I understand your question, sir, and I share your trying circumstance in more ways than one. This portrait of you, I must praise its likeness, came from somebody you knew moderately well. A lady who cannot contain herself! Though she must have mentioned you, your deeds were not discussed. But to be frank, I wish you would refrain from seeing her and putting such a strain upon the sacred bonds of marriage. For
you mean it? You're her husband? And she's your...
My wife, exactly. Thanks for your cumin.
Oh my God.
Yes, I'm always human. I like my marriage. Well, if you'll excuse me, I have to tell her father.
My place! Did him justice? She faced the memory when we swore that oath of loyalty? It applied to both or only one of us? I had a fight to win her back only out of spite! That vixen! But this outrage to my pride, you're making.
Monsieur, you haven't seen. Watch, you're unwell. It's lucky I grabbed you, almost fell.
It must have been a shock. It's so malady.
Will you accept a little hospitality? Come to my house and rest. You don't look strong.
You're very kind. I will, but not for long.
I sympathize, my boy, with your dilemma. Aren't you rather anxious to condemn her? What you've told me so far. Conclusively to prove her. These lapses on her part, although I grant it's hard to judge, as evidence seems.
You will have to catch her in the act!
Too rash. Investigate each fact. You should discover how she came to get this gift. Mm-hmm. And if she ever really met this man. Be patient, and if your impressions are confirmed, I'll see that she pays for her transgressions.
That's sensible advice. It's not unlikely that I read too much into one incident and feel too vividly. The scores were almost real. As for that miniature that made me quake, who knows? It may have even been a fake. So with an open mind... Still full of gallantry, the whelp. He's noticed me. He'll never dare to speak.
How could she give herself to such a freak?
Across a stranger. after that attractive display of wrath, I can't remain inactive. No man has a child to temper down. No man should try to keep his temper down under such blows unless he's but a clown. I'll comb the city for this hangman's bait, who in provoking Scarabelli taps face.
Well, it brought you up. What tasteful breeding.
You made me 10 years younger just by hitting my wishes.
Well, that's a turnabout.
I'll cite my reasons and you'll say that I was right. It's very possible.
That rogue lady. My so-called love has been deceiving me. He crept back home and
but he's coming.
Language now? How has she hurt you?
I had no doubts at all about her virtue until I heard the rumors. But I sped back here at once, praying I'd been misled. My overwhelming passion for her carried me home within a week to find her married.
Married? To whom?
To him!
To him!
To whom?
I assume that this is true?
I only said I was the husband of my wife!
Since I saw you with my fortune in your hand.
Yes, here it is.
And I heard you reprimand the woman it belonged to. On my life, you said yourself the woman was your wife.
She is! Without that locket thing, I swear, I never would have known of her affair.
What? My affair? I stood there in the street and found the locket lying at my feet. A little later, when this man looked ill and beaten gold doors to rest. But still, I didn't recognize him at the time.
I dropped the locket when I stood. So I'm responsible as things turn out for all of us. You took me home, if you recall. You see, you'd all be yelling viper and traitor if it weren't for me, the mediator.
Did all this happen to us, or did it not? For a while, my forehead felt really hot.
I'm not convinced yet that my premonitions were altogether false. I have suspicions.
In that case, I propose a lasting truce between us, in which I have more to lose than you. Let's trust each other to the full.
Agreed. But if you slip, beware the bull.
Good heavens, if this is true, what have I done? It's all my fault, the consequence of one distracted moment, thinking you had broken your marriage vow and gone back on your toe. I took revenge by consenting to a wedding I should have spent my life regretting. My father has my promise. I proceed. But here he comes.
Keep a pledge to me. Monsieur, I have returned, as you will note. Still deep in love and still ready to devote myself entirely to Celie and show that I'm worthy of her hand. And so.
Monsieur, you have returned, as I well note. Still deep in love, still ready to devote yourself entirely to Celie and show that you are worthy of her hand. And so I am at your service. Is no!
Is this the way you keep your oath?
It is, Monsieur. My duty makes me loath to break my word to Celie's name.
Your word to Lely was easily amended.
Daughter, you swore to me that you would take my decisions and abide me as your guide. Valerie! But here's his father. Come to make it final about the wedding plans I did. Well, Philip McCrin, what brings you without warning?
New information, which I learned this morning. It cancels our agreement. For my son, who was supposed to wed Celie, has done what none of us who are close to him suspected. For 4 months, he's been the undetected husband of Lise. I can't smell the match. She's wealthy, she's well-bred, it's a splendid cat.
And so it's ended! We'll start reconsidering. Let me reveal that long ago, I said I'd give Celie to this young man. Who's rich in honesty? Other riches. I wouldn't dream of having any other son-in-law but him.
Yes, handsome
couple. May you thrive, making me the happiest man alive.